tensions building all around, you can feel it in the air. It's more than a feeling, a new reality everywhere. I look and see the signs of the times. Yeah, it's coming, but they're all in denial. Everything you know, it's all about to change. See the sky cracking, it rains down flames. Oh man, they ain't ready for it. This is something that they can't ignore. Coming down like a meteor. This is more than a game, you better get ready. Shock the world.
Shock the world.
Shock the world. This is more than a game. You better get ready, go ahead, get ready. Shock the world.
Shock the world.
Shock the world. Our reality became unchained, like the jaws of a lion that can't be tamed. Welcome to the future, everything new. Walking on the edge, it's nothing that you're used to. Only the strong survive, you better catch your breath. Oh man, they ain't ready for it. This is something that they can't ignore. Coming down like a meteor. This is more than a game, you better get ready. Shock the world. Shock the world.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
This is more than a game.
This is more than a game.
You better get ready. Go ahead, get ready. Shock the world. Tensions building all around, you can feel it in the air. It's more than a feeling, a new reality everywhere. I look and see the signs of the times. Yeah, it's coming, but they're all in denial. Everything you know, it's all about to change. See the sky cracking, it rains down flames. Oh man, they ain't ready for it. This is something that they can't ignore. Coming down like a meteor. This is more than a game, you better get ready. Shock the world.
Game three of the day on tap here from Dallas, Texas, and Team Arizona Copper is back in action for their final round robin game here in the Lone Star Showcase. Team Arizona Copper will be taking on Team Texas, the hometown team where they didn't have to travel much, had to get in a car rather than go on a plane, but also they're a very good team. This is known as the two top teams in this division. There's two divisions, the Dallas division, which is what Team Copper is in, and then the Fort Worth division, which is what Team Arizona Black is in. These two teams, both 3-0. Team Copper won this morning 6-3 against Team Colorado. And Team Texas won 3-2 this morning against Team California, who Copper saw yesterday, and they won 5-3 over the kids from California. So in maroon, Team Copper, and in green, very sure, very apropos, Team Texas. Green, Dallas Stars, the green pillars here around the rink, here in Plano. Just 25 minutes north of Dallas. So Team Copper against Team Texas. It was a very good performance this morning from Reed Gramlich. Two goals for Gramlich for Team Copper. Jim added one as well. Stepien got in on the party. everyone on the roster has really contributed in some way or another, whether it be offensively, forechecking, defense, goaltending. Everyone has made an impact, and it'll most likely continue here as Gramlich, and we'll see his line mates are going to switch up the lines a little bit here as Welch, Stepien, and Gramlich are going to start it off. Let's talk about the goaltenders. Let's start with Team Texas. It'll be Tyler White to start it off. They're going to switch their goaltenders midway through, so we'll see Wyatt Wilhelm later in the game. But Tyler White will start it off, the 06-6-3 goaltender, the senior out of Trophy Club, Texas. He'll be the goaltender for Team Texas, and Logan Gibbs will be in net for Team Arizona Copper. Gibbs played the first game against California yesterday, made 19 saves in a 5-3 win. We're off and running here from Plano in what's sure to be a high firepower, high scoring, top tier hockey game here in the Dallas division at the Lone Star Showcase. Switchenberg bats out of midair looking for Welch. Texas whips it back in. Switchenberg on the backhand to the wall. Gramlich takes a hit. Here in the first minute, shot blocked by Stepien. Texas gets it right back. Pinkerman down to the half wall. Totolata on the side of the net. Switchenberg looking to get it out. A long offensive zone shift here for Texas as it comes in front. Blocked down into the corner. Englerth goes to it with Adams. And Texas comes out with it. About a minute in, it's been all Texas so far, all in the offensive zone. Shot goes wide from Murtha. As Gibbs saw it sail wide, Switchenberg will high flip it out. Looking for Gramlich, who was all the way down, he gets laid out in neutral ice. Reid Gramlich's speed has gotten him so much ice, has gotten him so much time in this tournament. Let's see if he can do it again. Gramlich turns with it, dodges a hit, turns over the puck, Texas the other way. And now right off the bench is Flynn to lay a hit on Green. I'm sure Cooper Flynn wasn't happy with Gramlich taking that hit earlier, just a couple seconds earlier. Now Flynn comes right off the bench and lays out his man, icing the call here. There's a few players on this Team Copper team that you really don't want to see bearing down in on you on maybe a puck in the corner, or and we're going to see that play there on the replay. You don't want to see Chase King, you don't want to see Kyle Kwinar, and you sure don't want to see Cooper Flynn, 6'6", 200 pounds, bearing in on the defenseman with the puck. Offensive zone draw off the icing. Kwinar puts it to an open corner. Texas's Thomas Fino looks exit at the zone. It's only been 2 minutes in to this one, but there's a different feeling about this game. And yes, it's just a round robin game. It's not like tomorrow where they'll be playing for a de facto championship. There is no trophy, there are no medals, but the number one and number two teams play each other, which will most likely be these two teams, depending on other results. Both teams are 3-0. One of them, of course, will have a loss unless we get a tie. Niles at the red line for McCaughey. He was looking for Gramlich off the bench. Here's that top unit. It goes over to Gramlich on the near side. He has Jim cutting toward the net. Jim, one more try for McCaughey. He wasn't there. Off the glass, kicked in by Niles. What a play from skate to stick all the way across. Gramlich on the backhand try and a save by White. Jim just tossed it across the zone. All three of these guys, I mentioned, they play Bobcats together on the same line. They know where each other are without even looking. It's like they have a little tracker in the back of their head. Where's Jim? Where's McCaughey? Where's Gramlich? They know before even looking. Gramlich in neutral ice across the red line. Texas takes it away from him. 3 minutes in, no shots in on net on either side. Irelson go chases us this one back for Team Copper. Mentioned it, Gibbs in net for Team Copper, White in net for Team Texas. Gabbery back on D for Texas in the Dallas Stars green, and all teams in this Lone Star Showcase went to the Stars versus Kraken game today. The Dallas Stars came out with a win, 3-1 against the Kraken last time we saw him. Mafeo's shot goes high and wide as he was cutting down the far side wing. Rahela kept it in. Kudakov in the circle, surrounded by three defensemen, somehow kept in from Rahela, tossed it into the open corner. Backhanded back by Maffeo. Eirelson down to Maffeo. Kudakov shot from that bumper position goes high and wide. Both teams trading long offensive zone shifts. Comes out to Butler. Butler on the backhand, put it behind the net. Kudakov can't chase up to it. Texas will break it out and come the other way. On the stick of Kiger. He'll circle the zone looking for a passing partner. Went off a stick. And we're going to get a whistle as the net comes off here. Gibbs also lost the stick, but the official is going to fix the net. We've had net problems in every rink, every net this weekend. That one just another example. A fast-moving game, a very defensive game so far. Both teams still looking for that first shot on net. Now Stepien takes the draw. Davis for Texas. Backhands it along the wall. Engler for Welch along the wall. Goes past him. McCaughey forechecks. Welch couldn't pick off the backhanded pass, and Texas will whip it in. Gibbs tries to play it with his stick by staying in the crease. Switchenberg has his man bottled up as the puck goes between his legs. He can't get it out. It pops out to Brady Engler, who will feed McCaughey, who stops on a dime and goes across ice to Parker Stepien. Stepien on the backhand, in front looking for Welch, loose puck in the slot. McCaughey's shot went off the side of the net. McCaughey went to that back post and almost got rewarded for it. He gets tied up in the corner. And now we're going to get a whistle, and McCaughey is going to be sent off, it looks like, for a penalty. He was caught up in that corner. Trying to get a number on that Texas defenseman. But Ryan McCaughey got a little too physical there. You're going to see it in that corner. A couple cross checks. And he's headed to the box. Roughing the call against McCaughey. First time to the power play today for either team. Team Texas has not had a lot of success on the man advantage so far this weekend. They are 3-0. They have scored a good amount of goals. However, just a 12.5% conversion rate on the power play for them. In terms of the penalty kill for Team Copper, 80%. Kudakov will come in on the forecheck. He sits in the box. Looking for Padilla. It touches his stick, which delays the icing. Engler tries the far side. Kept in by Adams and cleared out with the help of Quinar. White, the goaltender, will come out to play it. For Pinkerman, picked off by Switchenberg, and he high flips it right back in. 40 seconds gone in the power play. See how both teams respond. It has not been all sunshines and rainbows for Team Copper this weekend as Gibbs makes his first official save on a shot from the half wall and Flynn knocks it all the way down the ice. Team Copper has trailed in a good amount of their games, and not for long, but they trailed in two of their three wins. They did not trail against Indiana. They trailed against California. They trailed this morning against Colorado, but they have a lot of quick strike offense, and they don't, when they trail, they don't trail for long. Raish and Milstein go back behind the net. And the backhand it out, makes its way back to the blue line. Kiger works that half wall. Quarterback at the top is Bennett. Kiger down low. Texas working from the goal line out. Milstein pins his man to the boards, allows Niles to pick it up and flip it down. Play by Milstein to allow his D partner to pick it up and launch it all the way down the ice. Just 10 seconds to go in the penalty against McCaughey, which was for roughing. Kudakov blocks out his man. Another clear out to neutral. Bennett just puts it into the open corner. It pops out right in front of the net. Gibbs was attentive enough to get his stick on it and put it right back into a low danger zone. McCaughey's out of the box. This one hits the netting. A successful PK for Team Arizona. So back to 5-on-5, and back to a line that has been so influential and so important for this Team Copper team in Kane, Flynn, and Quinar. can talk all day about Graham Lake Gym and McCaughey, how good they are offensively, how they dominate when they're on the ice. But this line is almost like a line you put out there when a lot of when the other team's having a lot of momentum. Kane, who lays out his man behind the net. Kleinar lays a hit. Flynn is known to do the same thing. They bring a lot of physicality. They can tire out the other team. They've been cycling the puck well. They've had long offensive zone shifts. We get a whistle behind the play. Interference is the call. We're going to get a penalty. Let's see who they get. And it looks like Flynn is headed to the box. Another penalty against Team Arizona. Flynn for interference, just under a minute after they killed the first penalty. They'll go right back to the penalty kill, Team Arizona will. Flynn sits in the box, 5-on-4 in favor of Texas. If you can make one negative comment about what Team Arizona Copper has done this weekend, and there's not a lot because you win all three games, what can you say? You've scored a bunch of goals, 5, 6, and 5, 16 goals in three games. They have taken a good amount of penalties, and that's two straight now early in the first period. This one taken and cleared by Rahela. Other teams can benefit from the power play goals. They get momentum, they get the lead. As Stepien takes it away, Stepien's gonna try to go the other way. He'll put it all the way down and go for a change. Might have had numbers, but it was at the end of a shift, especially on the PK. He makes it short and allows Kleinar to come on. Over line and putting in deep is Gabory for Texas. Adams goes back behind the net. Engler looking to use the wall, and he does, as Phillips was too late to keep it in the zone. Switchingberg misses it. Davis comes back for Texas behind the net. Davis circles on the backhand. Drop pass to the D that was coming down right off the bench. Was not complete. That was Murtha. But he overskated out of this side. Phillips' shot off the stick of Putikov and out of play. 34 more seconds for Flynn in the penalty box. You see Putikov get his stick in the way. Phillips had a screen in front. Would have been a tough shot for Gibbs to see. He didn't have to see it. He only had to see it fly high and into the netting. Vitala can't win the draw for Texas. Goes over the far side where Butler tries to put along the wall. Kept in by Texas. Pinkerman back to the top. Shot by Phillips. Blocked by Englerth. Got his left shin on it. Did Brady Englerth. And puts it in to the half wall. It comes right back to him in the corner. He'll backhand it forward. Looking for Stepien, who's tried to spring Butler. Butler into the zone at the circle. His shot was blocked down. Murtha came all the way back for Texas. Now they come the other way. Drop pass for Adams. Stepien on him like glue. Picks it off and clears it out to neutral. This will be icing waved off as McCaughey applies the pressure. First shift for him after his penalty. 2-1 shot advantage for Team Texas. This is not exactly the game you expected when you look at the numbers, when you look at the statistics for both of these teams. It's high scoring, a lot of offensive firepower, and in the first 10 minutes, they've seen 3 shots on goal total. Icing the call here. You've seen each team now play 4 games, and Team Black will play right after this one. They play against Team DMV, which a lot of people didn't know what that was. Maybe because I'm from the East Coast, I know that DMV doesn't mean where you go for your car insurance or registration. It means DC, Maryland, and Virginia. Davis across the line for Texas. Raish on the backhand. Raish in front, loose puck, picked up by Gramlich. He puts it right back into harm's way. Almost found its way into the net. Milstein for Jim. Tyson picks it up for Texas. Jim gets caught up. We're going to have another penalty. 2 have gone against Team Copper already, and now it looks like it's going to be number 3. Ryan Jim to the box. For roughing. McCaw, he has taken one. Flynn has taken one. And now Jim has taken one. Third time to the PK for Team Copper. The old phrase is, well, if you keep putting yourself in trouble, and that's what Team Arizona is doing right now, eventually it's going to come back to haunt you. We'll see if they can kill off their third straight in the same period. Just a matter over 10 minutes. They've taken three. Tyson at the blue line. Down low for Raish. Raish to Tyson. Gibbs got a stick on it. Mark that down as his third save of the night. Kane comes in to stop Tyson. He took a stick up high. No call coming. Tyson holding his mouth. That's some time and space, and the shot was blocked away by Gibbs. Another penalty upcoming. This time, we'll see who they get. Niles was in that corner. And another arm up from the officials. They're going to say that Davis is going to the box for Team Texas. So a little bit of a break there for Team Arizona. They draw a penalty in their own defensive zone and will play 4-on-4 now as Davis is in the box for Texas and Jim is in the box for Arizona. Maffeo, Stepien, Rahela, 3-0-4 out there for Team Arizona along with Irelson. There's your four-man unit. And now with more time and space on the ice, let's see what they can do. Under 4 minutes to go in a scoreless first period. Maffeo dashes in. Goes past one, looking to take it off the stick of Gabbary. Stepien at the goal line. Stepien looking for Rahela, who's coming down from the blue line. Kept in for the moment. Rahela picks it off in neutral, but couldn't control. Gabbary will come back to his own end. If nobody scores, Team Arizona will have about a 30-second power play after Jim comes out of the box. Penalty from Davis in the offensive zone has definitely made the three penalties from Team Arizona make it much easier for this PK unit. They have played a lot throughout this entire tournament, which I'm sure they're happy about. If you're Coach Kenny McGinley, you're definitely not happy about it. You don't want to be on the PK all period long, especially with how much offensive firepower you have to offer. Want them playing at 5-on-5 or possibly 5-on-4 all the time you can. Green cuts in. Green, oh, what a goal! Incredible move. And Andrew Green puts it in the back of the net. He went past two, went to the backhand, and got it past Gibbs. Let's get another look to the backhand. Easy pickings for Andrew Green. That was silky. A 4-on-4 goal. Team Texas takes the lead. We'll see if Team Arizona can bounce right back. They've done so all tournament long. This morning, two goals, 14 seconds after Colorado scored. One was 14 seconds, the other one was 48 seconds, and then they went off from there. Here's a 3-on-2 rush. Englert looking for Gramlich. Big shot, Gramlich. He put it high. Assist go to Phillips on the goal by Green. As Texas leads 1-0 with 2:22 to go in the first. Jim is out of the box. It's a 31-second power play for Team Arizona. This is a perfect chance to get right back. Switchenberg, Englert, McCaughey, Jim, and Gramlich. Sometimes you see Stepien on here as well. He just comes off the ice. Gramlich in the circle. His shot saved by White. We mentioned a lot of the tall and physical skaters for this Team Arizona team. Not only can they lay the body, not only can they forecheck, but they can act as a great screen in front. And when you have Ryan McCaughey doing just that, it's tough for any goaltender to see. Now Stepien comes on. And he wins the draw back. Gramlich at the half wall, turned it over. Team Texas comes the other way. Good stick from Switchenberg to stop that. McCaughey over to Jim, looking for Gramlich. Loose puck and cleared down. Just 10 more seconds in the man advantage as we hit the 2-minute mark here in the first. Switchenberg's pass deflected off a shin pad, and Texas will come way out with it. Gramlich takes it away from Davis. Loose puck in their own end. Carey fighting for it as well. We're back to even strength, 5-on-5. Englert gets laid out. It comes right back in front. Loose puck. Switchenberg goes down. Penalty upcoming. It's going against Team Arizona. Another penalty. And it's not as if the officials are looking for these calls. These are very fair calls. And Englert is going to go to the box along with Adams. So a penalty for each side. They're going to set up at center ice, and it looks like we're going to play 4-on-4 again. And yes, we will be. However, the faceoff will take place in the Arizona defensive end, which this doesn't make a ton of sense, as both teams took a penalty. Adams for Texas, Englert for Arizona. Can go back to where the penalty took place, and that's exactly where this is. Green on the draw for Texas. He has that first and only goal. Shot from the blue line, saved from Gibbs, and the rebound as Gibbs puts it back in front, and Gibbs will hold and freeze it. Zachary Green has been, or check that, Andrew Green has been all over the ice for Texas here in the first period. Not only the goal, but there the tip on the shot from the blue line. Play 5-on-5, 1:24 to go in the first. Green pushes on the draw, kept in by Texas. Milstein along the boards. Green with it, gets it back out to the blue. Flynn comes out and lays a hit as Gibbs will cover up the shot from long range. Three ones on the scoreboard in terms of the clock. 1-1 in favor of the score. 1-0 for Texas. They have the one and only goal. Fino gets it ahead. Niles back. He turns within the corner. Ethan Niles looking to play the puck. Turns it over to Fino. Texas in the corner. Under a minute to go in period number one. Flynn looking to get it out. He can't. Shot from the blue line was blocked down from Kane. Milstein can't poke it forward. His stick was lifted. Kane can't control. And here comes Kwidar. Dodges a hit from Diski and whips it in. 30 seconds to go in period number one. It's the real first time this weekend that we've seen Team Arizona struggle in terms of their offense. Can give a lot of credit to that, of taking a lot of penalties. When you can't get a groove, you can't continue to roll lines, can't get any momentum. That's what happened here in the first. This one hits Niles up high. He comes back and deflects it out to Putikov, who will put it back behind the net. And that will take us to the end of period number one. A period that was filled with penalties, one goal, and not a lot of flow. A lot of whistles, a lot of men being sent to the box, and one goal in favor of Texas. Andrew Green got the marker. We'll head to the second, 1-0, Texas in front. Back here for period number two, Plano, Texas. 1-0, Team Texas in front. First time that Team Arizona has trailed at the end of a period here this weekend. It only took them 10 periods to do so, so not too bad when we're talking about this weekend for Team Copper. Tyler White back in net for Team Texas. Only had to make three saves in the first period. Logan Gibbs in net for Team Copper of Arizona. He had to make six saves on seven shots. Andrew Green, the only man with a goal so far in the first period. That was dealt with a lot of penalties. That dealt with a lot of whistles. Not a lot of flow for either side, especially as it went on. Hudakov's going to chase up to this one. Icing waved off as Gabbary watches him. Back in front from Mafeo. One try, no. Second try went to the side of the net. Might have been the best chance on offense so far for Team Arizona. Nick Mafeo coming right down Main Street. And Hudakov hit him on the stick. Now cutting back in front, centering pass, taken out of harm's way. Back to the blue line. Shot was deflected wide. Rahela back in his own corner. Clearing attempt, kept right in. Hudakov back, gets it here along the half wall, and now they break out. Mafeo with Butler, 2-on-2, all the way across. He thought he had Rahela, who was heading toward the bench. Rahela was going for a change. It would have been a 3-on-2 rush. And he needed a change after being out there for over a minute. Welch takes it to the corner, shouldered off the puck from Markinson. Gives it right back to Markinson in the corner. Racklow back behind his own net. It goes off the wall. And icing not called. The officials had both of their hands up. Nobody blew the whistle. Nobody ruled it not an icing. They didn't make the safe call sign when you're talking about baseball to rule it not an icing. Now Kane gets hit in neutral zone, and that's going to be a penalty. There's no whistle just yet. The officials have not called anything. This is very surprising. The call is Kane went down in neutral ice. Play was still going with Team Texas having the puck. That's a play that you have to rule down immediately. That was as Raich took down Kane, but Team Texas was coming down the other way, a 2-on-1 rush, and Gibbs had to make two big saves. Officials, a little bit late on that one, to say the least, and, well, there would have been problems if that puck went in the back of the net. Nevertheless, power play for Team Arizona. They get their first full one. They had about 30 seconds on the man advantage in that first period. Switchenberg at the top. He walks in. He shoots. It got deflected to the corner. Switchenberg, Gramlich, McCaughey, Stepien, and Jim, the five-man unit on the power play. McCaughey backhands it along the wall. Jim keeps it in. Stepien goes down to chase it against Murtha. Stepien lost his stick, and Murtha had an easy time to put it all the way down. Gibbs goes along the far wall for Jim. McCaughey across the logo. Ryan McCaughey on the near wing. Gets it past Phillips. He's going to get to the puck first and drop it for Stepien. Now Team Arizona can set it up, but Switchenberg was in the middle of the ice, and Jim didn't see it before he tossed the pass back to the point. Mentioned not a lot of flow as a 2-on-1 rush the other way. Drop pass in front, and they put it wide. Oh, what a chance. Now comes back in front. Gibbs going to hold it. A shorthanded chance for Team Texas. Gets the roar of the crowd going as it was an awesome drop pass back in front from Adams. He was coming down the slide. And then the forward in front just missed the net. It looked to be Murtha. Tyson was in there as well. An offensive zone faceoff for Team Texas here on the penalty kill for 50 seconds to go. Butler for Kane. Tips it in. Bennett comes back on D. He'll use the wall. Can't get it past Butler. Kane for Mafeo. He shoots. Hit off the mask of White. And it drops down for him to cover it. Strong shot from Nick Maffeo in the circle. You see it set up. Maffeo wide open, no one around him. And a hit up White up high. And he makes the save. Maffeo wins it back. Kane, quick shot, goes wide. Chase Kane had a goal just like that against Team California early yesterday morning. The goalie didn't even see Team Arizona win the draw and then shot it. Kane did before the goalie could even get down into the butterfly. Niles puts it in front. Fortunate bounce went off the pad of White, the netminder. Maffeo has Butler behind him. We'll go back to him. Butler over Niles. Drop pass for Welch. Welch looking for Butler all the way across. Goes off a stick. Still loose at the blue line and forced out by Green. Power play over as Raich comes out of the box. Just one official shot for Team Arizona. Englert gets taken down from behind as he was trying to join the rush. Welch on the forecheck. Team Texas will come out with it. Bennett across, looking for Carey. Now Diskey with the puck, puts it in front, nobody home. Fino gets hit along the wall by Butler. Here's Welch over the line. Welch stops, he'll put it in deep and go for a change. Stepien back behind, back to the blue line. Englert with time, his shot was blocked down. A diving forward, that one being Fino. Got a piece of that one with his upper body. This one goes off the stanchion, a good bounce for Cooper Flynn. Flynn on the backhand, down low for Kuinar. At the half wall. Kuinar tried to force it lower, taking off his stick by Fino. He had the block earlier in the shift. Taken off the puck by Stepien. He gets it back. Kuinar using his body as well. It gets past Englert. Carey tried to push it toward the net. Adams couldn't get his stick on it. Tapping it forward is Kuinar. Flynn lays out his man in front of the bench and dumped in from Texas. They're going to call this one icing, I believe. I don't think Texas reached that red line unless we have a penalty. They follow Flynn to the box. Adams is in there as well. That one might have been the first call. Interference against Adams and roughing against Flynn. There was no roughing from Flynn in front of his own bench. He hit his man and continued on with the play, and he's as confused as can be. And if you know anything about Cooper Flynn, he's not one to talk much against the officials or really be negative in any aspect. But in that case, he has a point to do so, and he did. We stay 5-on-5 after the coincidental minors interference and roughing the two calls. Adams and Flynn off for their respective teams. Jim in the corner. McCaughey right there to help him out with it. Gramlich right outside the half wall, looking for a pass. Phillips fighting for it, kept in from Englert. Pass toward the net, McCaughey with the tip and it went off the post. There's that first offensive chance from this top line. It comes in the tip of Ryan McCaughey and lays out his man along the wall. Icing waved off. Fata for Texas. Watched by Milstein. Down low, Engler. 6 minutes gone here in the second. As it goes off the glass, we're looking for Gramlich. Murtha will give it right back. Jim can't hold this one, and it'll be an icing. An odd game so far, and I mentioned it, a lot of penalties, a lot of men being sent to the box, but not a lot of flow. This game started out very quick, shots for each side, and high-powered offenses as we went end-to-end, and that's what you expected from these two teams. Both 3-0, Team Texas with 4.3 goals per game, Team Arizona with 5.3. However, haven't had that for the rest. It's been very choppy is the word you could use. A lot of whistles, a lot of stoppages. Davis gets it in deep. Maffeo comes out with it from his own goal. Kudakov on the right wing. Held by Murtha along the wall. Davis looking for it. Butler goes to work at the half wall. There's Kudakov out there, along with Kwinar, who's digging for it. And Rahela. Maffeo, as Rahela was down deep, he had to come back to the blue line, keeps it in. Now Rahela kept it in, tossed it toward the net, went wide of the short side. This one touches the netting and the whistle comes out with it. And Gracious Fan gives the puck right back. Sometimes you want a souvenir, and well, here, I don't think the souvenir is worth as much. Stepien on the draw. McCaughey tried to push it in toward the net, right off of it. It got blocked. Stepien, Welch, and McCaughey. Heyerlson comes down to keep it in. It bounces to the far corner. Tyson. Get some help. Rahela goes off the bench wall right in front of the Team Arizona bench. They are the home team in this game. Texas, the visiting team, which probably isn't how it should be, considering this is Texas. And yes, a lot of these kids on Team Texas are not from the Dallas-Fort Worth area. You have a lot of them from Houston, from the Houston area, but also some from Plano. Right here, this is their home rink. Murtha, number five, Charles Murtha, from right here in Plano, Texas. A little bit of an advantage. McCaughey, backdoor for Steppy, and he couldn't finish the job. For everything that's gone against Team Arizona so far this game, they're only down 1-0. McCaughey looking to push it forward. Steppy in toward the net. Welch picks it off. Welch tried a backhand pass, and Steppy in was in the circle. Took it on the backhand, backdoor. Welch, oh, what a save. Best one so far from Team Texas as they change their netminder, and Wyatt Wilhelm is now in net. Before the game, Coach Clark of Team Texas said they were going to split, and that's what they do as Gibbs makes the save on the sharp angle try. It's cleared out of caution. Wilhelm. The netminder for Texas makes his first save on a high danger chance from Welch. Pushed across really well to solve Welch. 6 minutes to go here in the middle frame. All the way back, shot from the blue line, gets blocked down, taken by Kiger. Stepien looks to put it forward. McCaughey puts his man into the wall. Have a great shot at that, right under our camera here. At the Plano ice rink, it's set right up on the glass, and you saw those players go to battle. Gabbary into the zone, drop pass for Carey. His shot was blocked down by Kwinar. Off the wall and out. Here's the hometown kid, Murtha. Carey backhands it forward, turned it over. Heyerlson to Kwinar over the line. Arizona look for their first one, and Willow makes it look pretty easy. Two saves for Wyatt Wilhelm so far. Team Copper has done the rotation in terms of each goalie getting a full game between Austin Schartle and Logan Gibbs. Schartle had the game this morning, and Gibbs has this one. Murtha turns with it in the corner. Shots now 12-7 in favor of Team Texas, looking for number 13. Kwinar comes back. Can't exit the zone. Kept in by Bracklow. Bracklow turned it over. Flynn. Reverse hit thrown by Switchenberg in front of the penalty box area. Murtha tries the far side wall and gets it there. With speed, it's Phillips through the neutral zone. Phillips to the backhand. Puts it in front. Gibbs puts it into the far corner. Englert behind his own net. And a game turnovers and a game of the puck bouncing on both teams. Icing waved off. Racklau pressured from Gramlich. Gramlich took the puck away in the corner. Now pins his man to the wall. McCaughey back behind the net, looking to stuff it at the side. Gramlich will try to wrap around and shoot, save from Willem. Maybe a sign of momentum turning Arizona's way as Gramlich gets behind the net. And Willem did a good job once again, going side to side. We'll see if this line can keep it up as they stay out there. McCaughey loses this draw. It's iced all the way down and icing the call. Nagler got there just in time. Faceoff comes right back to the right of Willem. Wyatt Willem, a 6'4 goalie. You have 6'3 Tyler White. You have 6'4 Wyatt Willem. Springtown, Texas. Junior. Comes back out to the blue line. Switchenberg got it in deep to Gramlich. Gramlich in front. McCaughey didn't get any of it. Put it wide. Switchenberg gets it right back. His shot goes wide of Willem. McCaughey looking to get on the loose puck, and he does. Got past three Texas forwards. Gramlich, Jim, McCaughey drags. Couldn't get the shot away. McCaughey one more time, blocked. He gets it back again. McCaughey, Jim shoots, save from Willem. And he covers this top line, and now some physicalities after the play. McCaughey, Gramlich, and Jim getting the offense going. This is the chance in front. McCaughey had three whacks at it. This was his third, and then Jim let it fly. And Willem caught it in his chest. A shift that could definitely turn this game. We'll see what the officials want to do here. They were separating each team for a good amount of time. No one to the box. Everybody calm and cool. 1-0 Texas in front here in the later stages of period number two. Maffeo back to the blue line. Kept in. Shot was tipped from Maffeo, but wide. We'll keep it into the backhand. Niles' his shot goes into the glove of Willem. Rebound chance as he dropped it. He didn't mean to. He brought his glove down to get the whistle and dropped it. Putikov was right there, but couldn't put it in the back of the net. Team Arizona definitely tilting the ice now. Maffeo at the goal line, feeds the point. Niles across. Englerth gets it down low with Milstein. Stick goes flying out of the hands of Butler. Pass Niles. Will it have enough for icing? It doesn't look like it will, and it won't. Niles does a good job of turning around and getting it to Maffeo in neutral ice. To Putikov, and he'll flip it in. The end of a longer shift. See if they have anything left in the tank. Putikov, first one of the puck. Back to Niles, who waits, now shoots. Wilhelm was looking behind him. It got deflected up and over. One more try from the blue line. Was blocked down from Team Texas's Padilla. And he'll come over the line with it. Padilla made his way past one, but not two. Back to the blue. Gibbs with the save. Rebound chance in front. Tiger shot, save, rebound at the side of the net, they score! It's Green again, his second of the game, and with exactly 2 minutes to go in the second, Team Texas is up 2-0. You give all the credit in the world, Gibbs with one save, Gibbs with another off the glove, and then wide open net for Andrew Green, his second of the game, to make it 2-0. They give the assist to. But you mentioned it, you give a lot of credit to Wyatt Willem, the goaltender for Texas. He makes a few big saves, and his team comes back and rewards him. Padilla gets an assist on the goal. Here comes Stepien in the other way, all the way across. Jim looking for one more pass as Welch was standing in front. Over the glove of Rahela and out of play. Put the face off. Right back in the Texas defensive zone. First time Team Arizona has been down two today.
I just wanted to jump in and say that that entire play, the clock, they forgot to start the clock.
So they're having clock problems now. Yeah, the officials not calling penalties earlier. You know, maybe a little hometown discount here for Team Texas, to say the least. Willem has trouble with it. Sick goes flying. That is Willem's stick back behind the net. The goalie doesn't have one. Welch feeds the front. Quick shot, save from Willem, and now the whistle. And why is the whistle being blown? The net is on, and for what reason is there a whistle there?
Hometown advantage.
The net was not off at all. And the Team Arizona had every break in the world go their way with Willem losing their stick. Why is there a whistle? Unfortunate for Team Copper, as they'll have to start off again. Jim lets it fly. It didn't go all the way through. One more try for Ryan Jim, and it got blocked. A few unfortunate calls going against Team Arizona here in the second period. 2-0, Texas in front. Cross-ice pass looking for Welch. It went behind him. Diskey for Texas. Over the line is Fata. Shot goes wide of the glove side. Murtha waits, shoots, it got blocked down by his own man. Now back in front, still loose, one with save, two saves by Gibbs, and he'll cover. It was Diskey in front. We're gonna see it again here. Gibbs makes save number one, tried to cover, couldn't control, and then finally puts his stomach over it and gets the whistle. The pace has definitely picked up here in the second. Less whistles, more offensive pace for both teams, and more chances. Both goaltenders have been fantastic. Bennett across. Adams' shot saved by Gibbs. Rebound chance, still loose. He has it. Wide open was Raish in front. The 6'4", 235-pound senior trying to put it past Gibbs. He had none of that. Had a couple whacks at it. And then the whistle. Under a minute to go here in period number two. Loose puck. Kwinar and Kane. Kwinar picks it up. Communication a little bit off there from Team Copper. It was a question of, oh, do you want it? Do you want it? All right, I'll take it. And then they weren't on the same page entering the zone. It would have been a 3-on-1 if they hurried. So Kane back in the faceoff dot. And he wins it back to Englert. See if Team Arizona has some last minute magic in them here in the second. Kwinar takes his man. Switchenberg at the blue line. Puts it toward the net, tipped in front, but wide. Kipped in by Englert with 25. Puts into the open corner. Flynn with speed. Takes it at the half wall. Flynn across, off the wall. Englert picks it up. Englert, sharp angle try. Willem makes the save, still loose. Where is it? Willem's down. The puck is still out. And another whistle. The official behind the net blew it, although the puck was in front of the net in the blue crease. Willem was down. Unfortunate, I mean, that's a spot where the official's in a tough spot. He can't see the puck all the way through Willem and all the bodies in the crease. And now it looks like they're gonna move the faceoff outside the zone or the offensive zone. 13 seconds to go in the second. They're gonna give a penalty. Or so it looked like, as the officials come together with 13 seconds to go here in the second. it's not a penalty. It's more of a timeout for the officials to explain themselves. And, well, there's been a lot of explaining to do here in the second period with a multitude of calls. I explain what's going on. 12, check that, 13.4 seconds to go here in the second. And here's the penalty shot. Switchenberg comes in. Switchenberg saved by Willem. The call was that Texas covered the puck in the crease with their glove. One of the forwards did, which allowed the penalty shot to occur. Switchenberg cannot put it home. Willem with another big save, and 13 seconds to go in the second. Can't put your full hand over the puck in the crease, and that's what happened. It wasn't the original reason of the whistle, but it came out of it. Another chance. Not successful from Team Copper. McCaughey wins it back with 12. Niles tried to get it toward the net. It hit his own man. Niles keeps it in. One more try with 7. McCaughey back against the wall. Pops out to Adams. Gramlich, McCaughey with 2. His shot blocked down by Murtha. And that'll take us to the end of the second frame. 2-0, Team Texas in front. They had 1 in the first and 1 in the second. Both had the same man, Andrew Green, the senior. 5'11", 165. Well, he's got 2 goals so far tonight. We'll be right back for period number 3. Right, back here for period number 3 here in Plano, Texas. 2-0, Team Texas in front. And I was just corrected. Team Texas did not go to the Dallas Stars game today. Well, you know, that is their home team. They don't really need to go and see them. They've probably all seen them before. But they got a little bit of extra rest when Team Arizona went over to the game and supported and wore their apparel, as did Team Midwest, Team Idaho, and others. Nevertheless, third period about to begin. 2-0, Team Texas in front. 15 minutes on the clock, and off we go. Switchenberg goes right down the middle. McCaughey gets laid out. Murtha across the line for Texas. To Patala, and a save from Gibbs. Gibbs has made 15, now 16 saves on 18 shots. The combination of Wyatt Willem and Tyler White for Team Texas have stopped all 14 chances from Team Arizona. Pinkerman held to the boards by Switchenberg. Loose puck flipped out by Englerth. Murtha comes back for Texas. T Team Texas has done so well, especially against this top line of Ramlich, Jim, and McConkey that has just dominated this tournament, or showcase, or whatever you want to call it, is they're holding the puck and really controlling play when they're on the ice, these three. You saw them with us at the end of that second period, with Jim with a couple chances, McConkey as well. See if they can continue here into the third. Tala at the half wall with Phillips. Switchenberg knocks it out. Loose puck. Ramlich can't get on this one. Puts it across. Jim shoots. Oh, what a save. Willem with the pad. Ryan Jim with two big shots that Willem has stopped. This one will not be an icing. That was a perfect clear from Team Texas. Maffeo the other way. Tried to thread it forward. Here comes Davis the other way. Davis on the backhand, easy flag. Another shot comes in front, puts it back behind the net. Niles and Milstein looking to dig it out of the pile. Davis comes in and lays a hit. It's Davis and Murkison back behind. Two on two, who's gonna help out? Maffeo looking to dig it out, and now we get a whistle. The officials deem too long. We're going to do the face-off. See what type of adjustments both teams make as well here in the third. It's been a very even game. The 2-0 score could easily be a 0-0 game, a 2-2 game, and honestly, if the goaltenders weren't as great, it could be a 4-4 game. These two teams are definitely very evenly matched. Butler lays out his man. Maffeo fighting for it. Tyson keeps it in. The breakout has been a problem for Team Arizona today. Now back in front. Backhand chance. Gibbs with the save. Another try. Gibbs got that one too, and he'll cover. And then after the play, Niles knocked down his man in front after they were still battling after the whistle. Davis went down as Maffeo laid him out. 2.5 gone here in the third. The officials talking over with the Arizona D-men. Niles and Butler and even Gibbs himself. Almost like a little calming presence. Hey, let's play a bit between the whistles, not after them. Well, here's someone who's played more than that between the whistles and Green. They're going to move the faceoff to neutral. Andrew Green will take the draw. He has two goals today. Both goals on the board for Texas off the stick of Andrew Green. First one was a pretty one. Cut through three Arizona defenders. Put a backhand in the back of the net. Or checked out a forehand. Started on the backhand, then went to the forehand. Niles looking for Butler cross ice. They find him. Butler knocks off one. Butler across. Putikov wasn't there. Now sharp angle try by Putikov. Goes to Milstein, save, rebound chance, and Willem will cover. That's that quick straight offense as the defense gets involved as well, tossing it toward the net. Or was being pressured from all around by Kiger, Lincoln Kiger, the D. Sharked him off and went in. We'll see what Stepien, Welch, and McCaughey can do. Back to the net, behind the net. Kiger gets it out with the help of his teammate and Adams. Let's see if Team Arizona gets something going at the start of their shifts. Been a lot at the end where they're tired and eventually they have to get a whistle and put on the new guys. Let's see if they can get something going here at the start. Niles comes back for it. On the forehand, Patala takes it away. Kept in by Texas at the blue. Back in front, save, rebound, try. Gibbs got both. Logan Gibbs keeping his team right within striking defense. Stepien here after they've been out for over 30 seconds. Have any juice left in the tank? Right off the bench. Eirelson shoots, saved by Willem. Nobody in front, he saw it the whole way. Rahela stops the puck from going to Adams. Welch across for Eirelson. Stepien tips it in. If that hit Adams coming toward the bench, it would have been too many men. It did not. Welch on the forecheck. Rahela keeps it in. Centering pass for Kane went over his stick. Gabarit and Kane go to battle. Welch still out there as well. He's that one forward who has to change. As Quinar and Kane come on, Flynn comes on next. Welch goes down deep. Welch in front looking for Kane, still loose in the slot. Welch gets it back. Try to find Eirelson at the blue. Gives it right back to Welch. Give and go play, broken up and cleared out to neutral. Rahela can't step up. Carey takes it back and Welch goes to the bench. Flynn comes on. Fino back to the blue. Phillips pressured and knocked into the boards as Quinar goes down with Phillips. And it comes out to neutral. A perfect first 5 minutes of the third period for Texas in terms of defending a lead. They've been possessing the puck more. They have not turned the puck over a lot. And here's a chance for Green, looking for three. Green in. Where's the puck? It's under Gibbs. Somehow he got that one, and I think Green kind of gave it to him. Let's see how that one came out. It looked like Gibbs had a lot of room on that far side. And he got a stick on it. Wow, what a save as he tossed the stick there. He was going the other way, but somehow reached out his right hand and got the stick and kept that puck out of the back of the net. Maybe even kept some hats off the ice as Green was looking for three. Here's the top unit, McCaughey, Gramlich, and Jim. Offense has to start getting going. Under 10 minutes to go here in the third. Mention it. Can Team Arizona get something going at the start of their shifts? It's that first 15 to 20 seconds where they're at their full energy and they can make any play they want. Can they get something going then? Team Texas has done it time and time again. Well, they haven't allowed that. And here's another opportunity. Phillips is shot, saved by Gibbs. And it's not pretty passing plays. It's not putting it down low, a give and go, or any sort of skill play. It's Phillips dashing through center ice, over the line, puck in on Gibbs, and gets him, his team, an offensive zone draw. McCaw, he can't win it. Jim onto the loose puck, has Gramlich with him. Jim off the wall, he didn't give it enough. McCaughey steps up and tips it in. Play is onside, but the puck goes in the netting. Just another example now, 35 seconds into this shift for the top unit. That's the first time they've gotten the puck in the offensive zone, and immediately a whistle. They'll stay out there. But you think about them now versus them 35 seconds ago and the energy levels. McCaughey wins it. Gramlich can't hold on to it. Texas comes out with it. Gramlich at the red line looking for the give and go with Jim. Rutschenberg on Fata. McCaughey, Gramlich has a lot of juice left. Taking off his stick. Gramlich turns in the corner. Back to the blue line. Engler takes his shot, blocked down at the top. Texas with numbers the other way. Switchenberg, the only D back. Green tried to put it across, and Switchenberg with a nice play. Now Engler and Fata went into the net. Both of them seem to be all right. Got up pretty quickly. But that's a dangerous play. Switchenberg did a good job of defending that two-on-one as the puck didn't come across, and then both got teed up and tied up as Fata went into the net first, Engler second. And finally, the officials have a reason to blow the whistle for the net coming off. Earlier, a little bit of premature whistles for that, and now Engler is going to be sent to the box for that play. The call is roughing as Englert goes to the box, a power play for Team Texas. both players got tied up trying to go toward the net, and there wasn't anything after the whistle. In the corner, Milstein, back in front. Gibbs got a piece. Fino with the chance. Kudakov tried to put it around one. He gets taken down, and a penalty against Team Texas. Tripping is the call. Remember, this happened in that first period where Team Arizona took four penalties. But that last one was negated by a penalty from Team Texas. So we'll play 4-on-4. It'll give some more space on the ice for Team AZ to work with. And they put out three guys, and really four guys, who benefit a whole lot from some more time and space. McCaughey, Jim, Gramlich, and Switchenberg. McCaughey wins it back. Switchenberg stands at the top. We'll see if they set up the 4-on-4. Switchenberg goes down deep, back to McCaughey at the top. McCaughey taken down, his stick goes flying. No arms go up. He'll have to go over and pick up his stick. Gramlich in the corner. Loses it. Texas comes back the other way. Switchenberg turns it over to Murkison. He gives it back to his D. Under 8 minutes now to go in the third. Gramlich in the circle. He'll rev up the engines. Gramlich with a lot of time, with a lot of ice in front of him. Gramlich through one, through two. Couldn't get past three. Back behind the net. McCaughey lays a big hit on Murtha. We still stay 4-on-4 as the high flip is successful from Team Texas. They get one off in terms of their players. Off the wall, Jim with room in the circle. Jim, drop pass. Gramlich, shoot, save. Rebound chance still in the slot. Gramlich still with it. McCaughey puts it off a stick and into the netting. High danger chances, but at the end of a long shift for those four men, Gramlich, his shot saved. It went over the stick of McCaughey, and then it came back to him on the pass from Gramlich, but off a stick and into the netting. Coming up on the 7 minute mark now. Fail wins it back for Stepien. Off the wall and back in his own zone is Niles. Niles, Rahela, Rafeo, and Stepien, the four-man unit. Icing waved off here. Stepien on the forecheck. Rahela will have to turn and chase. Niles on the backhand. Moves it ahead for Rafeo. Put right back in by Pinkerman. You couldn't draw up a better third period so far for Team Texas in terms of holding a lead and protecting it. A couple saves from their big goaltender in Willem. Mostly their defense and their neutral zone play. Rahela looking to move it down. Pinkerman stops his momentum. We're back to 5-on-5. Rahela's shot goes wide. Niles at the blue. Coming up on the 6 minute mark. Couple hits in that near side corner. Stepien took a couple with Butler. Here's Stepien looking to go down low. Maffeo's shot goes wide and hit Butler on the way. Team Arizona starting to push now. We're going to have a penalty. Arm goes up. And interference is the call against Team Texas. Going to be another power play for Team AZ. And another chance to get the zero off the scoreboard. This time it's Bennett. Jacob Bennett. To the box.
Did you catch that penalty in the background on the replay? Here, I'll run it again. Watch back in the corner.
You see Bennett in that corner with Butler. Yep. Raise the hands. Butler's stick goes flying. That's the call. It's a great look. Under 6 minutes to go. Power play for Team Arizona. Kane on the forecheck. Goes back out to Niles. He has room. Across. Butler's shot off a stick. He gets right back up on it. Welch, near side blue line, cuts to the center. All the way across. Back in front, looking back door from Maffeo. Power play more crisp, a lot more focus. And just as I say it, Texas picks up the puck and clears it down. Remember here in the third, the ice isn't going to be great. No ice cuts between periods here at the Lone Star Showcase. A lot of players have said the ice has not been great in third periods in either rink. Butler along the wall. Maffeo back behind the net. Another stick goes flying. Butler's going to go after it. It was Butler's stick both times. Switchenberg back in his own end. We'll see if they get the big boys out there. And they do. Switchenberg gloves it down all the way across. Stepien pulls the trigger, but just flubbed it. Couldn't get much on it. McCaughey pushes it forward. Stepien, McCaughey. McCaughey at the side of the net. Back behind now. Trying to find Gramlich in front. Here's Jim. Switchenberg. Back to Jim. It bounced on him. Jim all the way across. Loose puck. Switchenberg shoots. It goes wide. Kept in by Team AZ. 20 seconds to go on the man advantage. Switchenberg. Gramlich. Back to Switchenberg. They motion it over to Jim. Now Gramlich. Loose puck. Takes it on the forehand. 5 more seconds. Jim circled. McCaughey pulls the trigger. They score. Stepien. It's a power play goal. Team Arizona's on the board and cuts the lead in half. Parker Stepien gets the marker. They're going to give the assists to McCaughey and Jim. And the power play comes to play. So McCaughey and Jim set up Stepien, who is at the side of the net, wide open to put it in the back of the net. Under 4 minutes to go, and Team AZ down just one. Stepien had one this morning. Now he gets one here in the late game. Team AZ needs one more. Kuinar forces it out. We'll keep an eye on Gibbs in net. He's made a lot of big saves to keep this a two-goal game. And keep this at a one-goal disadvantage right now. As Flynn goes into the corner, he lays a hit. Kept in by Kuinar. Looking for Flynn down low. Given right back, and Rahela can't hold. Turned it back over. In the skates, Davis to Diskey. He'll circle the zone for Texas. Defender goes down, and now a chance the other way. Kuinar with a D down, looking for Green. Flynn waits. Flynn shoots. He put it wide. Somehow Cooper Flynn found that puck in his skates. It was bouncing left and right. And he gets a good shot off just wide. He'll flip it in under 3 minutes now. Welch and Maffeo on the forecheck. It'll come back to Butler. Butler caught up with the officials. Over the logo. You got a lot of snow on the ice. You can barely even see the Stars logo in the center. Loose puck, Green, Butler, backhanded across. 2-on-2 rush, Maffeo and Welch. Welch will put it around and go chase after it. He backhands it down. Maffeo at the half wall, right back down to Welch. Given right back where Milstein is at the red. 2:10 now on the clock. Keep an eye on Gibbs. This one was tipped in. Maffeo in on the forecheck. The rest of his line mates go for a change. Carry for Texas. Niles back in the corner. The net now comes off, as there was a battle back behind it. 1:47 on the clock. And a face-off where Team AZ can't pull their goalie because it's going to be in the defensive zone. That was a chance from Flynn. What a chance that was. Cooper Flynn, really impressive this weekend. Another save from Gibbs here with the blocker. McCaughey, Gramlich, and Jim on the ice. Puck hard to control right now. Stepien just saw that. It's the power play setup. It's only a 1D set for Team Arizona. And these five will play the rest of the way. Jim backhands it to mid-ice. Gramlich can't hold on to it. Reed Gramlich knocked down. Cleared out by Team Texas. Four forwards, 1D for Team AZ. Jim backhands it in. Stepien forechecks. This will be an icing. This is a perfect opportunity possibly for Team Arizona to pull their goalie. And Team AZ wants a timeout, and they're going to get it. Timeout for Team Arizona. 1:05 to go here in the third. They'll have a faceoff in the offensive zone. Most likely will pull Gibbs and have a 6-on-5 advantage. Needing just one to tie. We'll be right back. That was not a 30-second timeout. Probably a minute, minute 30. Here as they'll set it up. 6-on-5 with 1:05 to go. Jim, McCaughey, Stepien, Niles, Switchenberg, and Stepien. Check that Gramlich and Stepien in there. That's six. Team Arizona looking to come back down two with just under 5 minutes left. Reed Gramlich knows a little bit about that. Did that in the D1 semifinals 2 years ago. As the net's empty, it goes all the way down and just off to the left of the post. Niles comes back to touch it up. A few oohs and ahs as it was a slow-moving puck that just went to the left of the far post. Now 58 seconds. We'll see if they can get it set up and get it in the back of the net. McCaughey pushes off the draw. Back to the top, Switchenberg. Switchenberg walks in, shoots, save, rebound chance, still loose. Willem has it covered, and the whistle. Willem got pushed into the net. McCaughey was right in the middle of everything. Just a simple shot from Switchenberg, and the rebound had Willem out of position, but Team AZ couldn't control. As it was that bouncing puck, you see it consistently bouncing. McCaughey got a piece of it, but couldn't get much on it. And it goes back to the ice. They're going to bring the faceoff all the way back out to neutral. Team Texas wins this one. They'll swipe it down. And they'll wave off icing. Stepien across. Switchenberg gives it to Gramlich. Gramlich, drop pass. McCaughey shoots. Got blocked down, another try. Didn't make it toward the net. Here's Gramlich in the circle. His shot up and out of play. It stays in the offensive zone for Team Arizona. Willem has been outstanding for this Team Texas team. And they find a way in the next 27 seconds to get one past them. It goes into the corner. McCaughey fighting for it. Team Texas pinning it against the boards, looking to do anything to kill that time. Stepien looking to fish it out. An excellent job by Team Texas with 12, with 11, with 10. How long are they going to allow this play to go? They blew the whistle earlier for much. Three, two and one. That's it. 25 seconds in the corner. The puck was allowed to be fished out for. No whistle blown. And that'll be the end of it. 2-1, Team Texas takes this very competitive, close game. Team Texas goes 4-0 in round robin play. First loss for Team Arizona. They are 3-1. Make sure to follow us at Asha_hockey on Instagram, on Twitter, if you still have Facebook. For any updates on scheduling, now, this is the end of the round robin play, but each team, both Team Copper and Team Black, has one game tomorrow. But for the times and where that may be, and if we'll be able to stream it, the only way that we would not be able to stream it is if both teams are playing at the same time. For that, check out our social medias and check out the website Lone Star Tournaments, or check that Dallas Stars Tournaments. Make sure you get that right. DallasStarsTournaments.com for all your information. 2-1, Team Texas takes this one. Remember, tune in just about 30 minutes. Team Black will take on Team DMV. Same YouTube channel, different link for Black and DMV. We'll see you in just a little bit.